I think it's probably changed over the years. I used to be listening to music and trying to take in a bit of culture of each city, and now it's probably sat in my bedroom watching DVDs. It's a bit sad. A lot of bands tend to use sound checks, you know. Primal Scream I've seen doing Cold Turkey and millions of cover versions. We're pretty boring. We just do the songs that need to be done because we just want to get the hell out of there. You know, sound checks are the most tedious things on earth. And if we can get away with doing two songs, we will. And we just leave.
Ich glaube allerdings kaum, dass die Manic Street Preachers Songs von Coldplay zum Warm-up spielen.
Coldplay, all right. I think they write brilliant songs. I just think they're politically they're so naive, and I don't really want a kind of really rich person like he is. Patronizing me, telling me about world trade, you know. It's political systems that are wrong. You're not going to change things through charity. And it's just upper class guilt, you know. I've got so much money, so I've got to go to Haiti and perhaps get a tin of sugar in for free. Just fuck off, you know. I find it incredibly patronizing that they think someone like me, who's kind of working class, sort of needs to be told these things because they don't know.
Umgekehrt wäre es vielleicht möglich.
I respect the Manic Street Preachers a lot because I know they've always stood by their guns, and they've always never compromised anything, which is great.
Den Manic Street Preachers ist ja das widerfahren, was als eines der großen Mysterien im Popzirkus gilt. 1995 am Vorabend einer USA-Tour verschwindet Gitarrist und Texter Richie Edwards aus seinem Londoner Hotelzimmer. Moment, das ist jetzt eigentlich Didi Ramone, der ist doch an einer Überdosis. Egal, von Richie selbst fehlt bis heute jede Spur, nur sein Auto wurde auf einer Brücke gefunden. Und die Band überweist heute noch, nach über 7 Jahren, Richies Anteil an den Bandeinkünften auf ein Sperrkonto. Vor kurzem wurden angeblich Beine an der Küste von Wales gefunden, von denen man geglaubt hat, naja, was ist auch. Auch egal, sie waren es ja dann eh nicht. Ich fand das vorher sehr interessant, was die Bands so übereinander zu erzählen haben.
I did a bit of it in my philosophy and literature class. Can't remember anything about it. I think In Utero is one of the greatest albums ever. Never Like Nevermind just sounds like rehashed heavy metal to me. I mean, I was a big rock fan, and to me it just allowed a lot of people like Puddle of Mud and all these terrible bands to make music. It's not Kurt's fault, but I just think if you listen to Nevermind, it just sounds like dressed up Motley Crue.